There are some people in the dominant society who have very romantic ideas about Aboriginal people, about Tibetans. Tibet is a very romantic word. And if you live with and interact with any people anywhere, they're people.
She's 18 years old now. This started 10 years ago. They told her that it was either infection or the Buddhist monk had said that it might be retribution for having killed a frog when she was a small child.
If you're in a car crash and you have broken bones and they can be reset and you can be walking again afterward, if you don't have the money, they'll just send you home and you stay the rest of your life in bed. So our clinic's function, hopefully, is to provide that medical care for the people who otherwise wouldn't get any.
The first day, I think there were 100. Yesterday, maybe 150, 200. So you can see it's kind of exponentially getting bigger and bigger.
Tell them that we're only 5 doctors, and many, many people come from all around, and we can only see one at a time.
Every year, I'm scared to death that we might be challenged by customs. They might say, why does your group of 10 or 12 need 30,000 acetaminophen tablets? Tibetans say we live in a dark age. I like to think about that because then everything makes sense. In a dark age, we can at least try to retain a little glimmer of sanity.